Hi! Welcome back to Power Electronics Lectures. In this video, I'll talk about the importance of power electronics systems. We'll go through some applications of power electronics and we'll display the evolution of power electronics devices. Why is power electronics so important? The first thing we need to think about is the power conversion at high efficiency, as we explained in the previous lecture. So number one, why power electronics is so important? The power conversion at high efficiency. So here we have high efficiency. So power electronics can provide high efficiency if we compare this power, this efficiency with the traditional power systems. Secondly, power electronics provides lower costs since they integrate free and renewable energy resources. So number two is the lower cost. Either the installation costs, we know that in the past, the installation costs for renewable energy resources were very expensive, but nowadays the prices became lower and lower, and even the cost of using power electronics became cheaper because they are associated with the renewable energy resources, as we know that renewable energy resources are free. Also, power electronics can provide high reliability and they have long life if we use the right components and design them properly. So power electronics can provide high reliability. And longer life. For example, if you use electrolytic capacitors, these capacitors have short lifespan, so definitely they degrade the lifespan for the whole system. If you know the electrolytic capacitors, it comes like this. Okay. So these capacitors, these devices, the electrolytic capacitors, they have a very short lifespan if we compare them with other devices such as the film capacitors. Film capacitors, for example, can last for longer time, can live for longer time if we compare them with the electrolytic capacitors. So if you use, for example, film capacitors or ceramic capacitors, these have longer life, but their power rating is generally smaller than the electrolytic ones. So we need to optimize between the select the right device and the right power range that we are operating on and try to design the right thing. Also, power electronics mitigate the environmental and safety problems since they integrate more renewable and more renewable energy resources. We know that the growth of these clean resources such as PV and wind systems or wind turbines, you know, the PV panels and the wind turbines, the growth of these devices or these resources, which are power electronics intensive, put power electronics one of the top technologies that are supported by funding agencies and governments. It's enough to know that approximately 70% of the total generated electrical power flows through power electronics. So almost 70% of the total generated power comes through the power electronics devices. So power electronics is so important. And this number sooner or later will grow to 100%. Absolutely, this will happen. So our life will depend on power electronics. So if you select cheap devices or not reliable devices, so definitely our energy will be at risk. Power electronics covers a wide range of applications. Here we have some selected applications such as DC and AC regulated power supplies. So one of the applications is the DC power supplies, or DC or AC regulated power supplies. Okay. And also induction heating applications. Induction heating applications. Okay. If you talk about the transmission networks such as fax devices, you will find these all power electronics devices. So here we have the transmission networks. Fax devices, so on. Power line VARs and harmonic compensations and many other applications. Also, as we say, the photovoltaic systems, wind turbines, wind systems, waves, energy systems, and so on. Also, power electronics is heavily involved in motor drives, and electric vehicles, battery chargers, battery chargers, power supplies. There are loads of applications that are involved, that power electronics is involved in. Power electronics is also a multidisciplinary technology. An engineer specializing in this area should have knowledge in power semiconductor devices. They should have knowledge in converter circuits, electric machines, control systems, microcontrollers and DSPs, and FPGAs, and many other platforms that are used to generate the signals for the controllers. Also, the power electronics engineer should have knowledge on the power systems and simulation techniques and many other disciplines. As you can see here in this chart, power electronics is not that very old, but also is not that new technology. The thyristor's invention was in the mid of 1950s. Then after that, the applications of power devices became a necessity, and you will find that devices that can operate at higher switching frequency started to appear in the mid 70s. So here you'll find many devices that can use fast switching frequencies, such as the power MOSFETs, for example. Then in the 80s, you'll find that almost all of the devices that we use today, such as IGBTs, MOSFETs, thyristors, power diodes, and many other devices became more popular. Then after that, power electronics applications became more sophisticated and the need for more advanced systems became a priority. Nowadays, we deal with advanced control techniques, simulation technologies, converter topologies. In recent years, there are new devices also, which are the wide band gap devices. So after the MOSFETs and IGBTs, the wide band gap devices appears. Wide band gap devices. And these devices, the beautiful part of these devices is that they use high switching frequency, even much higher than the frequency used in MOSFETs and IGBTs. So here we have the high switching frequency. Also, they can tolerate the magic here for these devices. They can tolerate high voltage and high current levels if we compare them with the older devices. So they can operate with high power rating. The previous devices, if we talk about MOSFET, for example, if you want to increase the switching frequency, you will find that the power rating for the device became lower and lower. And if you want to deal with devices such as thyristors, you will find that this thyristor has a huge voltage level, or they can tolerate high voltage level or power rating. But the problem of the thyristor, then you cannot switch the thyristor using high switching frequency. But the magic here in these new devices, the wide band gap devices, such as silicon carbides, GaN devices, they can operate at high switching frequency, and devices such as silicon carbide can tolerate high voltage and high power levels, and also for the GaN. But generally, the silicon carbide can tolerate higher voltage than the gallium nitride devices. So will these devices shape the future of power electronics? We don't know. I have to stop here. So next video, we will talk about the need for high efficiency and the high density in power electronics systems. We are still in the introduction to a power electronics system. I think we need one or two more lectures in the introduction. So for that, keep with us and see you next time.